State House when I was 22 years old. I was straight out of college. I was actually born in November of 1979, so I'm technically a child of the 70s and a Gen Xer, but I'm really pretty darn close to the millennial movement. And the one thing that I would say is that any of us up here can probably point to our progressive bona fides and say, these are the issues where we're stronger than someone else on. And I have to hand it, Senator Kelly speaks with more authenticity on women's issues than I do, for very obvious reasons. And you know, Representative Ward has a stronger gun record than I would say probably anybody else up at this table. For me in particular, I have a very strong, I've been fighting for the rights of the LGBTQIA movement for my entire career. And then also I've dedicated the bulk of my career to working for the environment, something that, you know, we don't ever get to talk at these forums about the environment. I was on the Environment Committee and the Ag Committee, then I was the Secretary of Agriculture, I worked at the Environmental Protection Agency, and then I was Vice President at the Land Institute outside of Salina. If you're not familiar with that, it's one of the most progressive in the world. And millennials care about that, but more than everything else, I think millennials are worried about the direction of this state. We have an incredible state to be proud of. I'm very, very proud of it. I'm proud of my hometown. We had an African-American valedictorian of our high school class in Ellsworth in 1933, which is awesome. And as I watch the University of Missouri struggle with race relations, I think about the University of Kansas being integrated in 1870. This is an incredible state, but I think millennials, particularly because of the last 8 years, feel that the state is in decline. And they're worried about it. And we have not just an obligation, but as Democrats, an opportunity to send the message that we are going to take the state in a different direction. That's one of the other reasons that I've also called for immediately reinstating the civil protections for the LGBTQIA civil employees, because it sends an immediate message to everyone around the country, not just Kansas, that we as a state are back. The state that fought to be free is back. The state that gave women the right to vote for the rest of the country is back. The state of proud and supports education is back. We can do that, and we can do it with a young, energetic, enthusiastic message. We have that opportunity with my candidacy as governor as a Democrat.